take this function f of x, which is equal to 2x plus 1. Now we are trying to find the function as x is nearing 2, or in other words, as x is approaching 2. What actually happens? But x can never be equal to 2. It's just getting closer and closer to 2, but never getting exactly at 2. What happens? Now, from our previous illustration, we said the limit comes from the left and from the right, and they all approach to the number which we want to deal with. So let's write this mathematically. We are finding the limit of f of x as x is approaching 2. What will we get? But don't forget these 2 we have as x approaching 2 from the left and x approaching 2 from the right. So we must investigate for this and for that. Now let's draw a table to find certain values, then we plug them and see what's actually happening here. Now let's say we have the function here and we have the left hand side also. We take the same function and find what is happening at the right hand side of the functions as they are all approaching what? 2. So here we are going to take values of x which are less than 2, because all the numbers that are approaching 2 from the left are actually numbers that are less than 2. So we take this, and also for the second part of the table, we are taking values that are actually greater than 2. All numbers that are approaching 2 from the right are all what? Greater than 2. As we can see, if this is 2, all the numbers approaching from the left, we have 1, we have 0, we have minus 1, and to negative infinity. So all these numbers are what? Actually less than 2. And also those approaching from the right will be 3, 4, 5, and to positive infinity. And they are all what? Greater than 2. So that's why we create this table and we try to find out what those values should be. So let's pick at least 4 values which are less than 2 but closer to it. Since we can't take 2 exactly, let's take 1.9. You can say 1.9 is a little bit closer to 2. Also 1.99 is more closer to 2. Another one is 1.999. That one is also closer and closer to what? 2. Another one, 1.99999. It's also closer and closer to 2, but not exactly 2. Okay, here too, let's take values that are greater than 2, but closer. We can talk of 2.1 is closer to 2, but greater than 2. 2.01, that's also greater, but closer to 2. Also, you can take 2.001, more closer but greater than 2, and you can also take 2.00001, also greater but more closer to 2. Now, when we place 1.9 into our equation, which you can use your calculator to verify, so 2 times 1.9 plus 1 gives us 4.8. That's one decimal place. Also, when we replace x in our function by 1.99, we are going to get 4.8 9.8. Also, computing this for the same function, you'll be getting 4.998. And using this one also, computing it into the same function, you are going to get 4.99998. So we can see a trend. The more closer we get to 2, the more the numbers or the final result also increases. Now let's compute this side also, then we compare and see where we are actually arriving at. Placing 2.1 into the equation or the function, we get 5.2. Replacing x also by the second value, we get 5.02. This one also gives us 5.002. This one also gives us 5.00002. So you can do all this using your calculator. You just replace x by the values given. So now let me ask, what can we identify between the values we gain at the left hand side and the values that we gain at the right hand side as we are approaching to 2? You can find out that when we approximate this value, we are actually getting what? A value of 5. When we approximate this to get 5, approximate 5, approximate this 5. So that means that all these values are getting closer to what? 5. Closer and closer to 5. Now when we check the left hand side also, when we approximate this number, we still get 5. Because the decimal number, the decimal point is less than 5. So we can't add, we have to drop it. We can also take 5.02, 5.002, 5.0002. They are all actually what? Getting nearer and nearer to the number 5. So what we notice? The limit of this function 2x plus 1 as x is approaching 2 becomes 5. Intuitively, we can see that from the table. They are all getting closer and closer to 5. Meaning when we draw this graph or plot this on a graph, we can see that before we get to 2, both from the left and from the right, the height of that function will be getting as high as what? 5. That's comparing to the y-axis, we'll be getting a value of 5. So this is the main idea or concept behind limits. But don't forget, when the left-hand side limit is different from the right-hand side limit, we conclude that the limit of that function do not exist. But if they are equal, like we said early on, then we can say the limit of this function actually exists, which is 5. I hope this is very helpful. I would like to end this lesson here, but you can take this home and try creating the same table for this function and find out where the limit lies. If the limits are the same, then you conclude the limit exists, but if they're both left hand side and right hand side limits are not the same, you conclude the limit does not exist. It will be helpful when you take this home and try it as well. Now let's find the limit of the function sine x over x as x is approaching 0. So don't forget to find as x is approaching 0 from the left and as x is approaching 0 from the right. This one will help you to draw the same table and you will find whether the limit exists or it does not exist. With this brief explanation to the concept, I hope you gain a lot more about limits, not only computing limits, but actually the understanding of limits is now clear. But catch you again in our next tutorial when we draw more on limits.